Welcome to the third edition of 2 Second Lean. You might ask, why a third edition? Well, because frankly, I want to be with my own lean team, and I get so many requests for people asking me to speak and to come to our facility, I can never get anything done. So I'm doing my best to create a lean model where you can get all the information you need from the book, from the audio, and from the videos. So we're going to add 5 more chapters, and I think, and I hope, and I pray we'll answer every possible question. So here we go. The third edition of 2 Second Lean, Chapter 20, Lean All-Stars. I'm told over and over again by mid-level managers, my boss doesn't get it and won't support what I'm trying to do. My reply is always the same. Focus on yourself. Develop your own area of influence and be relentless about continuous improvement in your own life. If you adopt this approach, in short order, you will not only rise up and be promoted, but you will eventually be the leader of your own organization or another thoughtful organization that understands the power of true lean leadership. Lean leadership is not a little different than other leadership. It is fundamentally different. Typical leaders are concerned about themselves and their position and status. The lean leader is always thinking of the people they are responsible for and how they can teach, train, and improve and better the lives of everyone. This is servant leadership at the highest level. It is rare and it is a sought-after trait. On an almost regular basis, I'm asked if I know any lean leaders who would like a job managing or running a major organization. Unfortunately, the answer is always no. You see, I have met and come across hundreds of green belts and black belts, lean certified practitioners. However, few have the capacity to inspire people to greatness. Just today, I was asked again if I knew someone who I could recommend to step in a position of lean leadership in a major corporation. I replied back, I could only think of one person with the qualifications for this job. His name is Bruce. Below is Bruce's reply to me, and it is the essence of this chapter. When you get lean leadership, you're the bomb, a rare breed, and the sky is the limit. Here's Bruce's email back to me. Hi, Paul. Thank you for thinking of me in this position. I'm honored. It sounds like a terrific company. Like you, I am also reluctant to recommend anyone unless that person is a genuine lean all-star. I know several lean practitioners, but frankly, very, very few possess the dynamic, engaging personality you need to inspire and excite a workforce to embrace a cultural migration to lean. I feel it is unethical to recommend a lean practitioner just because they are a friend or an associate. I know just one person who I think would excel at this position. But as you might expect, he is well paid, approximately $200K a year, and really loves his job and his life in Mississippi. Sorry I was unable to provide any solid leads. Bruce. I recommended Bruce for the job not because he showed me graphs, charts, and statistical data about all their lean successes. He didn't try to wow me with lean terms or Japanese concepts. He didn't recite to me all the companies he transformed under his great leadership. I met Bruce at a talk that I gave. He came to learn even though he had 15 years more experience than I did. He sat at a table in the front row with 5 or 6 of his people, and they were all smiles and giddy about lean. They were happy because their culture, not their lean tools and terms, were central to their success. This is how I measure lean success. I have never seen a culture like this that didn't produce astounding results, but I have seen a lot of stats and no culture, and frankly, that's boring. Be a lean all-star. You will be loved, appreciated, and compensated beyond your wildest imagination. When I go to hire someone, I always hire for character and teach for skill. I can teach anybody to do the job, but character is a rare commodity. I have recently developed a new way to screen people who are interested in working for FastCap. I ask them to send me a quick 2 to 3 minute video telling me about themselves. You can learn so much from how people respond to this request. All-stars have no problem. They don't say they've never done it before. They say, I'll figure it out and I'll send it right over. Others hesitate and come up with reasons why they don't want to do it. The simplest assignment reveals so much about people. At the same time, it allows you to meet a lot more people so you can more efficiently make thoughtful decisions about potential new hires to the team. Below is a sample of the video resume I did to demonstrate how easy it is to make this happen on your iPhone. The second video resume is from Graham, one of our all-stars who moved to the Denver area. While I regret the fact that we are losing Graham, I'm going out of my way to help him find a phenomenal company where he can continue to have a huge impact because of his deep understanding of how to build a lean culture. Once again, the use of video is a powerful tool that sets you apart from everyone else. They say if you want to get someone's attention, you have to be remarkable or fascinating. Doing things the old way is not remarkable and is definitely not fascinating. Sending a video resume is at the very least extremely interesting, and to most people, it's remarkable. Learning to communicate in this edgy and interesting way makes you a lean all-star, and that's not a bad position to be in. The one thing, all-stars love people. And I want to emphasize, love people. They're not enthralled with themselves. They're enthralled with the capacity of other people and inspire them. Hey, I want to give you a little tip on how I find my videos on the internet, because I don't always have all the links right in front of me, but people say, hey, can you give me an example of that? It's really simple, because if you're listening to the audiobook, you don't necessarily have the link or a QR code that you can scan, but here's how I find most of my stuff. I just type in my name, Paul Akers, and then video resume, or Paul Akers lean desk, or Paul Akers morning meeting. It's very simple to find most of my videos and examples of what I'm talking about just by putting in my name and the concept that you want to find, and you'll be surprised how many will come up in Google right at the top.